right. So the the brain diagrams go in from 2482 5221 3A 3B 3C. Right? Now so those they follow the five phase exercises. Phase 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now what today we are going to do is only diagram 1 and 2. Huh? 2482 to 5221.
So that's a really big change, isn't it? From 2482 to 5221. It's a basic change.
Yeah, it's the introduction of the pause.
That's the introduction.
That is the introduction of the pause.
Yeah.
Now, first of all, what is an incoming impulse? Most everything is based on what is an incoming impulse, right? Now, an incoming impulse has different gradations of matter, from gross to subtle. So, this incoming impulse is coming through the five senses, right? Every moment, right? And the amount which is coming in every moment is 30,000. Right? 30,000. Now what happens to this 30,000? We will see later. Right? 30,000. What is this 30,000? So they are packets of energy. And they contain, it contains energy of different grades. Supposing we use Gurdjieff's terminology. So Gurdjieff has different notations for different grades of energy.
Yes. Who is Gurdjieff? Just briefly. I heard his name there for some time. But I didn't know who.
Okay, one of the books you wanted to
know
is In Search of the Miraculous.
In Search of
the Miraculous.
Miraculous.
By P.D. Ospinski.
By P.D.?
Ospinski. Ospinski. If you want the PDF, I can give it. PDF, I can give it. Sir, I can leave it.
It's an
e-copy.
Ospinski.
Ospinski. O-U-S-P-E-N-S-K-Y. So he Gurdjieff was a, we don't really know, but he may have been an Armenian or Georgian, we don't really know, but he came from that area. And he came to Russia around 1912. And this person, Ospinski, met him. And Ospinski was a famous reporter and writer. And he spent 6 years with Gurdjieff. And he has put down Gurdjieff's teaching in one book called In Search of the Miraculous. Right? Now Gurdjieff has given gradations of matter. It is what he calls them as hydrogens, but I won't go into all that today. Just gradations of matter. Now, so what does this incoming impulse, this packet of energy contain? So it will contain matter of different grades, different grades, right? So supposing the lowest grade which it will contain is matter of the earth. Matter of the earth, right? So Gurdjieff calls that as 48. He gives a name, gradation. We just take this just now, we won't, right? It contains matter of the planets.
right? Which is, he calls as
24, right?
And it contains matter of the sun, which he calls as
12.
So from gross to subtle, this is what is there in the in this incoming impulse, right?
Is in the incoming impulse.
Now, how much of each? How much of each?
You will say, but I don't want matter of this too. That is, so it is not on in us, right?
This is predecided,
predecided.
So everybody has a structure. What Tavadiya ji calls a structure of acceptance.
It's a duster also, huh? Tumne khabar chahiye na?
Structure of acceptance. Right?
What does it mean?
Yeah. The structure of acceptance in Gurdjieff's language is called as level of being. Level of being.
So, as you 48, 24 and 12, that comes from the impulse. So
you're listening to me.
Okay.
So my voice, which is going through your ears, it contains matter of these three grades and maybe even more subtle, but we are just now just taking.
Right, but I can't control that because it's from outside coming to me.
Yes, but how much of which?
Okay. That also I can't control, right? Because that is
that will be decided by you, not by
how I interpret
me. I may want to give you more matter of 12.
Okay.
But if it is not in your structure to accept it, you will not accept that. You will only accept so much.
So it depends on the level of being.
Level of being.
Right?
See, there are two paths. The path of knowledge and the path of being. And both of these must move together. Right? So I have a lot of knowledge. But in my being, I still get very irritated, very angry, I hold hurts, I hold prejudices, right? I complain all the time. So, my being is here, my knowledge is here. Knowledge, I know everything, Paramatma, Atma, everything I know. But my being is here. So, there's a big gap between knowledge and being, right? So, level of being, Tavadiya ji calls it as structure of acceptance, or he has given another name for it, he calls it the spectrum. Spectrum means the amount I can digest. I cannot digest more. Amount I can digest. Right? Now we'll see the same incoming impulse in another way. It is that incoming impulse is actually a triad, a packet of energy, which is structured in a certain ratio of tamas, rajas, sattva. According to Tavadiya ji, intellectual, right? Emotional, sense. This is his notation. Well, so that incoming impulse which is coming through the five senses, right? Okay. It is matter in an electronic state. It is matter in an electronic state. And as we saw, 30,000 are flowing into the body brain system every second. Every second, 30,000 of these impulses are flowing into the body brain system. Right? Now, This is good in a way. I have not recorded all this in English.
Oh, nice. So
it's good in a way. I'm the one who easy person. You okay then?
Yes.
Yeah? Okay. Right. Should I repeat everything I've done, said or?
If you could in a few sentences.
We are talking about something called incoming impulses. These are those packets of energy which flow in through the five senses every second. 30,000 of them flow in. Each impulse is a packet of energy which contains energy of different grades, right? And they all intermingle in that packet, right? So if we were to see, we just took three grades. The three grades are energy of the earth or matter of the earth, which we have labeled as 48. Energy of the planets, which is subtle, so we have labeled that as 24. And energy of the sun, which is more subtle, we have labeled as 12. So this packet which is coming in contains those three energies. Right.
Is the source of this impulse, 30,000, is it the environment?
Yeah, from around. It is. What? Yes, the source of this is what Tauriyanji will call as universal mind, or universal divine mind is the word he uses. Huh? Universal.
This is universal mind.
So, just as I breathe and the breath comes out and becomes your breath,
that's true.
Right?
That's true.
Similarly, what thoughts I am throwing out becomes
very good.
Your thoughts, they become a part of the larger pool, which is called the universal mind.
So
when it comes into me, I call it my mind. Otherwise, it is universal.
Right.
You're doing your conferencing also?
No. I just started my laptop, so in case if somebody calls me,
Okay. So this is clear, huh? That packet contains, but we cannot take in energy of one grade only, because we are structured in a certain way. So our structure only allows us a certain ratio. If I say I want more finer energy, it's not possible. You get it? Just like a dog can hear a certain frequency, but man cannot hear that frequency, right? So a dog is structured different from a human being, right?
So each human being would be different than
Right? That would be his level of being, his structure. Right. Now, another way to look at this incoming impulse is it contains three forces, tamas, rajas and sattva. It is structure. Right? So, it is a triad of three forces, tamas, rajas and sattva. Right? Now, again I may say I want to accept only sattva, it is not possible, because my structure says that you can accept only more of tamas. That does not mean sattva will not come. A certain amount of sattva has to come in to balance the tamas and rajas. Right? This much is clear? Okay. Now, what happens to these 30,000 that come in? This 30,000 which come in, it's matter in an electronic state. So, they are divided into three parts of 10,000 each. Three parts of 10,000 each. Twenty thousand are used up by the body brain automatically. 10,000 go in upkeep of memory.
What is the meaning of upkeep of memory?
We have a whole library of memory patterns brought on from birth to birth, right. And those have to be maintained. They need energy to maintain. Library is needed, dusting is needed, whatever. Right? So,
control and go out just without doing anything to us.
They are used by the body directly. The body intelligence uses them directly. We don't do anything with them.
Oh, I see. Okay. And the 10,000 is for the upkeep of the man.
10,000 for upkeep of the body.
Oh, that's for after the body.
Right? So, the balance 10,000 from the senses goes into the subtle brain, the astral brain or manas. So 10,000 come and hits what is called the manas. I'll just give a little talk on what the manas is, then we'll go ahead from there. Now we have different inner instruments, like I have outer instruments like the five sense organs, the five organs of action. We have different inner instruments called the manas, the aham and the buddhi. Right? Now, what does the manas do? What is the function of the manas? So I see you, right? So you are broken down into electromagnetic impulses which flow through my five senses, and they have to be reconstructed on the screen of the chitta, screen of the mind. And this process is done by the manas.
So whatever you are taking it in, as per your being, you would restructure it and you create picture as per your being.
No, we have not yet interpreted it.
Okay, it just comes in that way.
But what you are saying is correct. There is still that screen of structure of acceptance.
Right.
So something from you may come into me which may not come into him, or vice versa. That is because of our structure of
being,
acceptance.
But in an inner instrument, why there is an
aham?
Just three.
Man, buddhi, na aham.
Okay, and then why there is no chit?
Chit we have not taken.
Okay.
Chit we have not taken. Just now we just take the manas. I'm just saying these are inner instruments.
Okay.
Isn't it the same instrument really performing different functions?
It is in a way the same instrument performing different functions, only some of the functions are more subtle than the other functions. Like the functions performed by the manas are little gross compared to those performed by the ahankar, and the functions performed by the ahankar are little gross compared to what is performed by the buddhi.
So buddhi is at the top, yeah?
Right. The most subtle part.
I thought Ahankar would be at the lowest.
No, manas.
Manas is lowest.
Manas is the tamas. Tamas is Ahankar is rajas.
So true.
And buddhi is sattva. Right?
So even before interpretation, how it comes in and how we see it or perceive it would be different to individual to individual.
That's true. That's true. A carpenter sees a tree, it's different from an artist sees a tree.
Yeah, this is a
good example. So, now, this manas is the astral brain.
Okay.
It's the astral brain. Yesterday you were asking, thinking principle was asking.
Yeah.
Huh? Thinking, physical manas plus physical brain equals to thinking instrument. Thinking instrument.
That's manas.
This is very, Tavadiya ji is very, you know, his personal like study chair. A lot of it is Gurja. But there's also his personal, it is his personal study.
So, when Gurja was a yogi in a way, then he was a yogi.
Yeah.
And practice this Eastern yoga even being in
a, in a very Western and scientific way. Very, very Western.
In which year he has been?
I think he died in 1949.
Oh, so it's not very old. No. Western.
Right.
And why do we refer to him more than
To understand the Indian rishis, we have to use it.
Yes.
Today we are understanding the Mahabharata because of Guruji.
Oh, I see.
He has given the technique of how to understand.
Understand.
Right. So, manas. Now, this matter which is coming in is electronic. Manas is molecular. Swaha, bhuva. Swaha, bhuva. So, at its maximum capacity, if it is working, the manas can only process
And if the capacity is now, 10,000 would be too much because it's a electronic matter.
10,000 is matter flowing in, which is matter in an electronic state. It has to be processed by the manas, so it is brought down. There is a step down transformer. It has to be processed in a molecular way, right?
So out of 10,000, when it becomes 120, a person chooses which 120.
Okay. We're coming to that. Okay. We're coming to that, right? Okay. So it can only process 120. So 10,000 minus 120. Right? 9, 8, 8, 0. They're totally wasted. And they vanish into a part of the brain called the silent area, or in yogic terms, the bindu.
Is this part on the right middle part? This bindu is on the right.
It should be the right midbrain. In the diagram, he has shown left midbrain.
Oh, I see. It is right. And that's what I thought. It's right middle part.
Right.
You can proceed.
Yeah, yeah. You take your time. Take your time.
So when it vanishes, it just.
It's like a black hole. We don't know what is happening to it.
It just gets sucked in.
It gets sucked in and that's it.
So it doesn't damage or fill up bindu with garbage or anything.
Somewhere the divine fragment is using this. We don't know what is happening.
I just wonder how could they quantify this? How could they quantify this?
All this has been quantified by one of Gurdjieff's disciples called Charles Daly King.
I see.
And it is he who has quantified this. And he must have really worked hard to come to these figures. Yeah.
But Ravindra, do you think this would have been in the realization they would have seen it?
Yeah.
I mean, it's you can just take a calculator and do things.
Ajay, today when science today is saying that 3 million bits of information flow into the brain. It's very similar. Very similar.
I've heard that.
Right?
They're telling us what to do.
So now we are not interested in all this. We are only interested in this?
120. 120 is the one which affects manas.
Right. Now these are flowing in. These 120 electromagnetic impulses, right? And something is coming to meet them.
And that which is coming to meet them is called an identical memory pattern. Memory pattern. Now, these memory patterns are lying in a brain called brain 2B, I think in the lay, when he taught us it was one terminology, and when he printed the book he changed the terminology.
Is that right?
I think it is now brain 3B. Chala, jo chala, deep memory se
bacha. Deep memory,
In the old Buddhist thing it was 2B.
2A
and now
is 2B.
It, 2A is shallow. 2A, 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 2A.
Yeah,
2B. And in this one?
Yeah, that is the same one here in this one.
Okay, then in between here change.
That is actually discourses.
So then it's okay, this one is okay.
Is it right part of the brain, lower part or left part of the brain?
No, this is the memory pool.
Yeah.
So deep memory, shallow memory. We are now talking about deep memory.
Deep memory.
So that is brain 2B. In the diagram, brain 2B. This is deep memory. Deep memory has a one-way valve. Means my consciousness cannot go in, but the pattern can come
out.
Right? Just now I'm sitting silently, I'll say I have no anger in me.
Okay.
That does not mean I have no anger in me. It's lying in the deep memory and my consciousness cannot go in. Only if it comes out can I see it.
Okay, so it can only come out. That's one way where okay.
You get what I'm trying to say? And it can only come out to meet a
incoming impulse.
It can only come out to meet an incoming impulse.
Yeah.
The valve opens and it comes, right? Like he says, the impulses are traveling up the backbone. This meeting is done somewhere in the talu area. Right? Okay. So, now what decides what meets what? So, what is the meaning of the word identical? What do we mean by the word identical?
Pertaining to what this?
So, we know that this is structured in tamas, rajas and sattva, right? It is a triad. A triad of...
This is the incoming.
This is the incoming one.
Okay. And the meeting one is...
Supposing we say that 60, 20, 20.
Yeah.
Right? So, this is coming with this. This must have an identical intensity to this. That is why we give it identical. So again, this will be 60, 20, 20. Suthir?
You cannot repeat that.
Can you disturb?
Totally chaos.
Cheerless.
Now you understand how it is structured.
I know. So, I have nothing to do with it.
But I have never met you.
Right, exactly.
But even before you come, I dislike you.
So what I thought in that scenario or in that matter, you must have had some bad experience with me in some life. That is why...
Nothing, this is all chaotic, nothing to do with any life. Or if you want to say, this is all life, all past lives.
Right. Oh, so if we dislike someone, that does not mean that person has harmed us in our past life or if... It's all chaotic. That is why we must ignore it.
That's very interesting.
We don't know what is bringing it out. Oh wow. It's so
sad. Should not pay attention. Is that the logic behind it?
You pay attention, but don't make a prejudice out of it.
Okay. In other words, just looking at the...
And it manyata kya dharin bhi?
Manyata. If you see in life, many times there have been people whom we have rejected totally
and later on they have played an important role in our life. And we've always wondered why when we met this person for the first time, you know, we didn't like him, but it was something which was absolutely chaotic. It had nothing to do with that person.
So, Rajbhai, in a way, the first impression is not the real impression, is what we are saying. Like when we look at the person,
unless,
this feeling comes.
Unless we have a perception free of
these things.
It's a conscious perception.
Yes.
So now, if we take the brain, the incoming impulses have come up here. Now, one thing when we were talking about the manas, which I forgot to say, is that the manas does not need all the impulses.
But
in Sankhya, we have a terminology called Tanmatra. Tanmatra means, matra means measure. Tan means minimum. Tanu. Minimum measure. Tanmatra. So supposing I am seeing you and you are broken down into say millions of electromagnetic impulses, to reconstruct you inside, I don't need everything. The manas needs a very minimum measure, which it is called as Tanmatra.
It doesn't need all the.
It doesn't need all
the electrons.
You see.
And but at the same time, you would be picking certain tanmatra, and I would be picking certain tanmatra.
There is.
Okay.
According to my structure of
acceptance.
This is all automatic. All automatic to my structure.
That is why we perceive them differently.
Now they meet these identical memory pattern here in the tongue. Right? Tongue. This point. Right? Brain stem.
That's the space.
Medulla. Medulla. Right? Now, once the identical pattern meets the incoming impulse, it decodes the incoming impulse. There is a decoding done. And out of these 120 impulses, 120 thoughts are made every
second.
Every second. These thoughts travel up round the brain cortex like this, and they come to this area, which is called the forebrain.
That is the registering area. That is the
registration area. Now when
towered on the top of the
they flow like this up here. This consists of four centers, the I, E, S and M. Sattva, Rajas, Tamas, Resultant. Right? Now, what happens in this area? In this area, out of these 120 thoughts, now here is where modern science and Tauriyaji are a little different, because he wrote this much before modern science has come out with all the
data
of the brain. So according to him, out of these 120, the brain verbalizes 12 thoughts.
12 thoughts.
Per second. So this inner chatter which is going on all the time in us, right? This inner chatter, which is in language, it is not in thoughts.
It is in language.
This we cannot see. When we talk about thoughts, we are talking about this. We are not talking about this.
So these are causing the chatter in our brain.
This is causing the chatter.
Oh, this is 12.
Well, what he is saying, today's science says
16 thoughts are formed every second. Wow, think about it, just 12 thoughts is causing this much chaos or...
Right? Now, these thoughts will be what you call registered in a ratio of 2, 4, 8. Because this is habitual. This is habitual.
So this is like an ordinary person.
Right? 2, 4, 8. What does it mean? 8 is sex or excitement. 4 is reaction. And 2 is level of awareness. Right? Now, all this will fight inside. Reaction will go with like and dislike. This will go with attraction and repulsion. Get it? I am attracted to the theater. But the theater is going to get over at 2 o'clock in the morning. At 3 o'clock in the morning, I want to get up and practice. So now there is a conflict. So there is a like of the theater, but before that there was an excitement of the theater. She told me that the latest this James Bond movie has come. Right? So there was an excitement, an attraction. Then I realized that I like James Bond, but the movie is going to get over at 2 o'clock in the morning and I want to get up at 4 o'clock in the morning. So this guy here will say, I want to get up at 4 o'clock. But he will have no say in the matter. These two will say, we are going to the movie. One day if we don't do the exercise, what difference does it make? Right?
So, first excitement is the one.
First is excitement. 8. That is the immediate.
I want it.
Huh.
Then the reaction.
The like and dislike.
I like and dislike.
Like.
And then you will.
Then I'll say, alright, but what about the exercise in the morning?
And this is smile.
But these are too powerful. They will overpower that guy. That is sattva.
So does this mean before we reach at certain level, we should have less interaction with people or interaction with now?
No.
We have to learn to live with it.
Yeah.
I thought gradually we would build it up, that because the excitement is so much outside, that level of awareness would be so much.
Now,
so the reaction is rajas also.
The reaction is rajas. The excitement which excites the reaction is tamas. And the intellectual, what is right or wrong, or what should be done or not be done, is sattva. Right? I do or I don't do. Right? But here I just want to do it. Right? The don't do doesn't have much say in the matter. It's only 2, and this is 4 and 8.
It is discrimination which is deciding for that matter, right?
And then what I go to see the movie is the final moving center. The final thought, which is the resultant of all the fight inside, and that is what he calls as two.
So it doesn't have much say.
That doesn't have any, that is the final resultant. Everything is over. This whole process in this ISM center, the
struggle is over.
And this is the end result.
Very good.
He has a term for this, resultant intensity.
It's called resultant intensity.
Intensity.
એટલે આ રીતે રજીસ્ટર થાય છે ફર્સ્ટ જે રજીસ્ટ્રેશન એરિયા છે ત્યાં
રજીસ્ટ્રેશન એરિયામાં
248
જે બધી ગોળમથોળ થાય છે શું કહેવાય એને ખીચડી પકવા એ રજીસ્ટ્રેશન એરિયા
બરાબર એટલે શરૂઆત આવી
હવે શું થશે વોટ આમાં ક્યાં મેથેમેટિક્સ ક્યાં ગોટાળો ક્યાં છે આ તો 120
But
we acted on either 12 or 16, whichever. Supposing we take today's science, so we say 16.
So
what happened to
104?
So every moment, we are throwing out this 104 through the Ajna. As the exhaust of a car. It's throwing out. It becomes somebody else's thought patterns.
So whatever our garbage becomes someone else's thought patterns. Oh my God.
Like my breath becomes somebody else's breath. This becomes somebody else's.
And right? Guruji, this is the food for the moon?
Food for the moon. This is all food for the moon. Four food and eight is the... food for the moon.
So from Ajna we should
We'll just take a little bit of Gurja over here because she has brought it up. We have just brought it up. I'll just it will make it more clear.
Is it in the way
We must understand that what we have done now is 2 4 8 2. 2 4 8 2. Now we'll go to the next diagram, 5 2 2. What?
Is it Patanjali also saying the same thing, or this is a new their interpretation as this?
You see, Patanjali has given small sutras. I'll take the sutras which are related to this. I'll take a few of them. At the end, I'll take them.
That's fine.
Well, let's first go through these two diagrams,
Once we understand the basic, then it'll be easier to understand.
Incoming impulse.
It could be from your subconscious level. Also.
Identical memory
pattern.
And man.
And manas. So this incoming impulse must meet the identical memory pattern in a medium of the mind, manas. Of the mind, manas. It must meet in this medium called manas. And this manas is molecular. So what does it mean it is molecular? You want tea?
No.
What does it mean it is molecular?
It's not as fine as the electronic.
That is okay, but what is the characteristic of a molecule? Water is molecular. So what is the characteristic of a molecular substance? It takes the shape of the vessel you pour it into. It can take any shape. Right? Patanjali is saying, vritti sarupyam itaratra. At any point in time, that drashta, tada drashtu swarupe avasthanam, that seer, has taken the shape of any vritti. He's identified. He's taken the shape of any vritti. Sarupya, become the shape of any vritti. So because this manas is molecular, it takes the shape of. Right? Now, these impulses are flowing in like a river, right? Very fast. Manas is molecular. So manas is actually going out through the sense organs and becoming the river which is flowing in, because it can take its shape off. It can take the shape off. Now, when we pause,
what do you mean by flowing out? Flowing out of where?
To meet it.
To meet the incoming impulse.
The incoming impulse is coming, but manas is also going out to receive it. Yes, and it is bringing it
in.
So the manas is in the shape of a river. Mm-hmm. You see, manas is in the shape of a river.
it's coming with a force along with its content.
So what happens in a pause? When I pause, what happens?
It stops the river.
I dam the
river.
I dam the river. I'm holding back manas. I'm holding back the mind. I'm saying I'm not allowing you to get involved.
With the
pause. And that comes with the introduction of consciousness.
Oh, it is the consciousness.
Right. So the moment I bring in consciousness, I'm holding back manas.
I see.
I'm holding back manas. I'm not allowing it to flow with the incoming impulses, and the identical memory pattern and the incoming impulse, they meet, but they meet in a vacuum.
What does it
mean? Manas nahi.
Man.
Huh?
Man nahi is absent.
Ha. The mind is absent. I have held it back.
Oh, so, it, okay, there's nothing to meet.
They meet.
They meet, but...
They meet.
Uh-huh.
But because manas is not present, I have held it back through the pause.
I see.
Meditation.
Okay.
I have held it back.
Okay.
I paused over there. In that very pausing, I have dammed the river.
Okay.
For that fraction of a second or whatever I call
whatever.
It.
Whatever. Okay. So that the incoming impulse is coming to meet that we have stopped the mind. So then it has no place to go.
No, they meet, but there is no medium.
Meet with what?
The incoming impulse and the identical memory pattern meet.
Oh, okay.
But that medium of mind I have taken away.
Oh, I see.
The manas I have taken away by pausing over there.
I see.
You get it? So
there is no action.
There is no action in the sense a thought cannot be formed. Because for a thought to be formed, they all three have to be present. The incoming impulse, identical memory pattern and
manas. Okay, since we stopped, so the thought cannot be formed.
The thought cannot be
formed.
These two meet in a vacuum. This incoming impulse is pure now. It is not decoded. It is pure universal mind. It has not become individual mind.
Okay, okay. Okay.
You get it?
Uh-huh.
This memory pattern, because it could not fulfill its purpose of
meeting
and decoding the incoming impulse,
uh-huh.
It dies.
The memory pattern.
Because it can't go back now. Unless it gets reinforced, it cannot go back. That is the law. 1 plus 1 can go back, but 1 cannot go back.
Oh, I see.
That old, so, old mafia gangs, if you get one more member, you come back. But if you come back without someone, then you are beheaded. I shoot you.
So, in other words, there is no medium for it to go back.
To make a thought. It cannot make a...
Medium is not there. And then, because of lack of attention, actually that's what is amount to, the lack of attention, it is, lack of attention, it dies down, no?
Supposing you're doing the prism exercise,
okay.
Supposing you're doing the prism exercise, now thoughts are flowing like this at 120 per
second,
they're coming to the registration
area.
Right? Now, you're looking into the prism, at one point the manas detaches from the thought.
Oh, I see.
So the thought is not formed, so there's a gap over here. The prism vanishes.
I see. Because the gets tired or what?
No, you're not paying attention, you're putting the attention through and through the prism, far away. There is a sudden moment where the manas is detached, and in that moment a thought cannot be
formed. Oh, because I'm looking at my attention is
through and through the prism.
Through the prism. And what does prism indicate?
No indication. It has not detached my attention. The manas has been blocked for that pause. It has introduced the pause.
It has introduced the pause. actually what it has done, it has introduced
the pause, right? So what has happened? Out of those 100 anger which I had lying inside, now remain 99. One pattern is disintegrated. Mm-hmm. So the bondage of anger which I had is broken. Karma is broken. Right? Mm-hmm. Now.
So my question now is that incoming impulse came. You said something nonsense to me. I thought of getting angry at you.
Yeah.
But I paused. So identical memory has come out.
Right.
And I have paused. But anger has come out.
Yeah. So now that's a good question, in the sense that supposing I am very angry on a friend and I'm writing a letter to him. And I write the letter and I'm on the verge of posting it, and then I tear it apart.
Right.
So I have not paused completely, but I work towards a pause. See, there are many in-between stages. What we are talking just now is the complete pause. But before the complete pause happens, there will be many in-between stages.
So not letting it out is the stage.
It's the first stage. Non-expression of negative emotion.
My experience, personal experience is that when somebody has said something which you feel it's not wrong, you say, and at that time you're very angry.
Right.
You know, you're not ready to forgive or this, you know, like, but after a day or 2 days, it dawns on you that you could have done this. It was not necessary. What is it then?
Because for 2 days, the memory was creating a new incoming impulse.
Memory was creating
a new incoming impulse. By remembering what she told me yesterday, I'm creating a new incoming impulse.
Oh, I see. I see. And that has died.
That has now died down. So again, it is a kind of pause.
It's a kind of pause.
But
that's a longer pause.
So even after 5 minutes or 10 minutes, if the thought comes that I should not have,
it is a kind of pause. But it is not a complete pause. When one thought dies, we have not made, then we have at least introduced one pause.
And
we have reached the state 5-2-2, where rajas is 2, tamas is 2, but now sattva is 5, they cannot pull it. It's held over. And the result is 1.
So if the thought is not formed, but if the thought is formed, but you have not expressed it,
The thought is formed, you have not expressed, so this is the first step in the pause.
First step in the pause.
And a point will come where the thought will not be formed.
Because if you are persistent and like...
You are moving, yeah.
Like with your consciousness, when you realize, hey, this is again and again, it is useless to worry about, that means I am bringing my consciousness into effect to discriminate. And actually I am increasing my... the
satya. So at one point where the thought is not formed, it will become 5-2-2. Now they can't pull it.
Because that discrimination.
Right. And by doing it over and over and over again, we create a structure.
Now, let us go a little further from here. This is, I've explained the two diagrams. We'll just, in short, I'll explain the next 2-3 diagrams. In short.
અજયભાઈ, તો જયારે ઇમ્પલ્સ નથી આવતા હોતા કે બેઠા છીએ શાંતિથી, સોરી એસે હી બેઠે, તો કન્ટિન્યુઅસ થોટ તો ચાલુ રહેતે હૈ,
એટલે મેમરી માંથી ઇમ્પલ્સ નવા આવે છે ને.
અચ્છા,
ધ મેમરી ક્રિએટ્સ અ ન્યુ ઇમ્પલ્સ.
ઓકે,
ઓફ કોર્સ.
આઈ હર્ટ યુ યસ્ટરડે, બટ ટુડે આઈ એમ નોટ ઇન ફ્રન્ટ ઓફ યુ, બટ યુ રીમેમ્બર એન્ડ યુ ક્રિએટ અ ન્યુ ઇનકમિંગ ઇમ્પલ્સ.
Oh, so impulse doesn't have to come from outside only.
No, the memory creates the impulse. What decodes the impulse is the identical memory pattern. Tame samjho, e tamne yaad aavyu is shallow memory.
Right.
I hurt you yesterday is shallow memory.
Right.
What is decoding is not shallow memory. It is coming from the
outside.
Deep memory.
Deep memory.
You are only remembering the incident.
That is shallow memory.
That incident becomes an incoming impulse.
કન્ટિન્યુઅસ ચાલુ જ રહે. આપણને ખબર હોય કે ના હોય.
So even when very adverse situations are not happening, if we are just sitting, we should keep thinking this kind of thoughts to make incoming impulse more sattvic through memory.
We just do the rhythm.
What I mean is, let's say you got angry at me yesterday, and today I'm thinking of you, right? And I would say, yeah, whatever we did, I should not have done. I should have let him go and forgive him and whatnot.
Right.
So instead of, oh, he did that and how dare he and all that, those kind of...
You're reinforcing the pattern.
Right. Instead of thinking in that manner, I should be thinking in this manner.
Forgiving.
Then you're not reinforcing the pattern.
So whatever the incoming impulse came from the memory, I'm just not reinforcing.
Because if you're reinforcing, the bondage is increasing.
So that is brooding.
Brooding.
Brooding does
mean that. Right? So this is 5-2-2.
And it could come through the pause.
Yes, we have introduced the pause.
Or for that matter, Gayatri Mantra would... you know, with the...
Whatever, in the end it introduces the pause.
It introduces pause.
Right?
So can you explain that in context of the other one? You know, Savarji said about point of contact and seat of administration. The point of contact, he said that, is say, registration area. And the seat of administration would be shallow memory.
Shallow memory, yeah.
And anahat is again the point of contact.
That is where the will, where the pause comes from the anahat.
Yeah, and the seat of administration for anahat.
We'll have to do that some other day. Because it comes from the anahat. The pause comes from the anahat.
Yeah.
That is where he shows 2, 4, 8, 2.
That is controlled by memory deep. That's what he said.
Right. The incoming, the identical pattern comes from memory deep. The memory comes from memory shallow. The pause comes from anahat.
Okay.
What is relation?
Means it is the emotional energy which creates the pause. We won't go into that today. We won't go into that. It'll become too complicated.
It becomes like
No. If you can just repeat the last sentence, you know, the one that you said that memory comes from the.
I remember the incident.
Yeah.
So shallow memory is creating a new incoming impulse, which again a memory pattern is coming to. Me. Right?
So it is becoming this shallow memory is becoming an incoming impulse and it beats against
instead of her hurting me, I am remembering she hurt me.
You are remembering and then it is also doing the same thing. Then.
Same thing.
It is doing the same thing.
You are reinforcing the memory pattern.
But if you say that I forgive and...
then you are not reinforcing.
Then you are not reinforced, and then maybe next time it doesn't even do that.
Yeah. Better
now she is not directly instrumental in reinforcing the memory. We are ourselves reinforcing the whole thing.
So in that case, let's say you hurt me yesterday, and I'm thinking of it today. So incoming impulse came from my
memory.
Shallow memory,
right?
But the anger came from my deep memory.
And identical memory came from the deep memory. I remembered that happened and whatnot. And how daring and whatnot. The brooding.
That is all shallow memory.
No, brooding.
The anger which comes in.
Okay.
You see, I remember that you hurt me yesterday. The minute I remember, that is coming from deep memory. You did this, you did that is all coming from shallow memory.
Okay.
Okay,
but so my strong reaction towards this came from
Result of the
intensity is coming from the deep memory.
Okay. And in that scenario, if I would just observe my feeling.
Or I stay with my feeling.
Right, stay.
I don't interpret it at all.
That's what I mean. I feel what I'm feeling and I just stay there.
Stay there.
I don't blame, start blaming.
So that is the beginning of pause. I brought consciousness in. This is the beginning of pause. I'm not allowing the identical memory pattern to decode it. And the identical memory pattern will die.
So even in brooding also, we can create this kind of pause and over again in our thinking, and not just when things actually happen.
That is called pratikraman. It's not for brooding. It is called prayaschit.
No. When we are brooding over and when the emotions come out.
What you are saying, to bring it out and to consciously be free of it. That is we are working consciously. Otherwise we are brooding and the pattern is getting reinforced.
So okay, if we bring it up, let's say the past one, and we are not bringing from the deep memory to meet that, and
the deep memory is not in our control.
So it will come from deep memory.
The minute I remember that she hurt me, from the deep memory the anger will come out.
Come out.
Right. So and it will decode everything.
How do I pause it at that moment?
So at that moment where the anger is coming, I just stay with the anger. I don't allow my thinking to go ahead. Or if she hurt me, then again a new thought is coming, a new incoming impulse.
Yeah.
Don't walk with it. Huh.
Just hold it. Pause over there.
Like Swami says to us, don't follow the thought.
Just pause.
Just don't follow the thought.
Stand statue in the mind.
Wherever thought, you don't follow it.
Yeah, just stand statue.
And you say that,
instead
of
giving the attention to the thought.
Mm-hmm. So, whatever the remaining impulses, like you said, 104 of them, they just go out or vanishes through the Ajna. But there is another one also, it says that it follows the same path it came through, it goes back through the same route from which it came. One impulse comes.
I think that is in brain 3B3C, but I don't know.
Not at that level? It follows the same path?
No, that I'll have to find out.
So because the impulse comes, then it basically goes, it is absorbed by the nadis, it goes into the astral body.
I think in brain 3C, you are circulating one impulse.
No, I'm not talking about circulating, no. Mm-hmm. That is how the impulse, that is the path of the impulse, right? It goes to the astral body first, travels to the nadi, then it goes to the...
That is the way. I have just said it meets the astral brain. Yeah, but I have not talked about anything.
No. What I mean to say, then it goes and when it comes back, it says that it follows the same path and goes out through the same way it came. So, at whatever point of contact...
I have to read that. I don't remember it. What I feel is that what you are saying is it makes the pathways in the manas stronger and stronger. It reinforces the same pathway because it is always moving along the same pathway. That is what I feel you are saying, but I'll have to find out. I don't remember this. Okay. Now, supposing we have paused, and here he says that basically he says 1 second.
1 second.
That our pause has now become so powerful that we are able to pause for
1 second.
1 second.
Oh, 1 second pause is powerful?
Very, very powerful.
It is called Dharna.
So we are able to save how many thoughts?
120.
Right? This state in Patanjali is called as Dharna.
So in those commercial thing, looking at a thing and doing static is not a dharana.
Now, supposing we take the brain. Previously when the thoughts were formed, they used to move round like this. Now they won't move like this.
It came to the memory and went to the registration.
Yes. Instead of going up there, they will open a channel over here called the central brain cavity. The Brahmarandra. Right?
So this central brain cavity is being formed after 5221.
It's already formed, it's being opened.
It's being opened.
Once we start pausing.
Once we have the energy we have enough of petrol.
this much force is minimum.
We have cut down that by 1 second.
Dharna pachi je shakya bane.
Minimum energy of 120 thoughts are cut to like. Brahmarandra. So it is.
This is what is the
Brahmarandra. It is now opening, but for that you need the minimum energy of saving 120
thoughts.
Right? Now from here it will reach the registration area.
Okay.
Bypassing
memory.
This memory.
So memory was up there, and before that, that central cavity has been formed.
See, you killed the memory pattern, and if you went above here, I would remember yesterday you hurt me.
Right.
So now it is going through here, so it has bypassed that memory. But it is taking a journey, and it is taking a journey through the brain. It is taking a journey.
Instead of going through the memory, it is just made a new passage.
And the first stop in that journey is brain 2B.
And what is 2B?
Deep memory.
Deep memory.
So we are just bypassing shallow memory?
Now we have gone into deep memory. Our consciousness has gone into deep memory. Yes. Oh.
Okay. But for that second only, Rajanbhai? For that Rajan second, you pause the... For that second only, na? Varipasi again, incoming impulse away, varipasi, sorry.
Dharna thayo ne, ek second, and it's a big thing, very, very big thing, very, very big thing.
I have read Swami say that for 11 seconds, if you do, like, you know, without blinking your eye, maybe the same thing like the physical thing, but I really don't understand, so that's what I'm doing. Is if you do it for 11 seconds without blinking your eye, and if you do it 11 times, that's meditation.
Something like this.
Something like this.
Yeah. But this is scientific, this is giving you a science behind it.
So in other words, if you could pause for 1 second without remembering it, it has made a new, and we have taken our consciousness into deep memory. And what does it do? If you try to erase the, observe the things
the
in
the... power of perception changes.
Power of perception.
What was this question?
What happens when it goes into the deep memory? So our power of perception changes.
Perception in whatever we perceive.
Because I am looking at you. When it came through here, it was decoded 248 by the registration area. Right?
Okay.
Now it is going through here. It is, before it is registered over here, something else is happening on the way.
Because it's going through the consciousness is going through the
deep memory.
And that is just looking at the deep memory.
The perception changes.
I kind of, you know, understand. The perception has, in other words, instead of you thinking one way, now you're thinking the other.
Perception is
drashti.
Acha.
So that is what drashtabhava is.
No, the seeing, the drashtabhava is the pause which you introduced.
Oh, I see. That's the pause.
Right?
Okay. My question is, can you put 5, 2, 2, 1? I'm not saying right up. but show the figure and show the other figure and tell me what happened in that one. I understood 5-2-1, but the
deep memory go to consciousness.
That's what you're the central cavity part. What exactly happened in that?
See, from 2-4-8, we made a pause
and became
5-2-2.
Right.
In 5-2-2, we stopped one thought. Right?
Oh, in 5-2-2-1.
We stopped one thought. Now we are increasing this 5-2-2 to 1 second, because one thought is 1 upon 20 over second. Right? To 1 second. So we have killed 120 memory patterns. Right? And we have saved the energy which was going to go out in a reaction of 120 incoming
impulses. I see.
So that energy together of 120 incoming impulses is very powerful. It opens the central brain cavity.
Wow.
You get it? It's going into the central brain cavity. And it is coming straight, instead of coming like this, it is coming like this to the registration area. Instead of going round, it is coming like this to the rim. And on the way, it goes through brain 2B, the deep memory.
What happens?
So before the identical memory that was coming from deep memory, we could not go in. Now we can.
We have gone in. We have gone in. This is something akin to the dream world. Deep dreaming, not the night dreams, early night dreams. Something akin to the dream world. What is happening over here? The perception changes. You get it? First the perception was that you did this to me, that is why I am angry. Now the perception is that because you did this to me, I was free of anger. Reverse the unit perception.
Oh, in other words, once he got angry, and now my perception is, instead of that anger coming up, I say, now I have become free of anger.
No, because she got angry, that anger came up, I killed it, so I am free of that anger. The perception has changed. She is not at fault. You see, the whole way I live my life has changed. Everything has changed in my life.
So then you find peace everywhere in every situation.
Nobody can disturb you because it's only instrumental causes.
It's only instrumental.
Second thing is that brain 2B, one lifetime is equal to 3 minutes.
Brain 2,
I didn't get that.
17 years is equal to 10 years.
Say 70 years, here is 70 years, but in a dream 70 years is 3 minutes. 3 minutes, 70 years pura thi gaya. I live all 70 years in 3 minutes. In a, not even in a 3-2 minute dream, I live all 70 years.
What does it mean?
The speed.
The speed of perception has changed.
Changed so much that if I... No, I'm having a dream, or am I...
Our dreams are coming from 2B, what I'm trying to say. So, in a dream...
And here you are talking about dream means dream at night.
At night, je dream aave che. In that dream, I live my whole lifetime in 3 minutes.
That is, that height of speed is.
Time is compressed, no?
Because the perception is
changed. Rajendra, I don't know, have you read that Anita Murjani's near death experience? I have to send you that.
In practical life, what has it done to you?
My life has changed, I just told you. Till now I was finding fault with the world outside.
I see.
Now I know nobody is at fault for anything.
Nani hati pehle maitri ni chamti hai jate hum.
So this 1 second pass is when my memory has when my this intellectual this centers have ratioed 5 to 2 to 1. So then
now we are not in 5, we are going to 3A. 5 to 2 1, we stopped one thought. Now we have stopped 120 thoughts
at a time.
Before we stopped only one thought, now we stopped 120 thoughts. The reason is because
we are pausing more and more and more. We are learning to pause often. And we reach at the level that more and more thoughts before the thought comes.
Our pause has now expanded to 1 second.
Second.
Where initially it was only a fraction of a second.
Oh, okay. I see. Okay, before it was a fraction of a second, but now we have increased with the practice to 1 second. And
we now have the energy of 120 incoming impulses or thoughts.
That I understood. Because it's not meeting the identical from the deep memory, and those are not being they're not being but how about this 12? I thought there were only 12 which were coming, and rest 104 were being used with the other part of
it. Just say, yeah.
They were just
You are right. We started from 12 and we have reached 120 to that point. Our pause has become so powerful.
It has.
So now my question is that we create that central cavity, right?
No, that is already there. We open it.
We open that, right? What do we do by going in deep memory? What would we gain? What would we take advantage of?
That is what I said. Our perception changes.
Okay.
Because one lifetime equal to 3 minutes.
How do we get that number?
Supposing I was to understand you, you would say, okay, in my young days I did this, then I did this, this is how I lived my 40, 50 years, whatever.
Right.
Right? Mm. So it takes time.
Right.
But in this perception of 3 minutes, I see you in a whole lifetime. That much of intelligence I gave.
Intelligence you gave.
Imagine.
So when people say that any saint I go to, or if I go to Didi, she would look at me and she would know whole life that I've lived so far, or what I'm going to live further.
Because
that is what we gave.
Because in 3 minutes, he can see 70 years. 3 minutes is equal to 70 years.
Wow, so just by pausing.
This is a very crude example of
perception.
So, we learn that fast also.
You just grasp like this. First, I was reading the book like this, now I'm reading the book like this.
What was this question?
Means you learn faster.
Is it like Swami Vivekananda said that one time he was going through this encyclopedia, he just turned the pages so that you can ask many questions.
Like that.
So shallow memory is mind.
This is also mind. This is 2B. These are all different parts of the mind.
Acha.
Different parts of the mind.
If you can draw the picture, where is this 2B?
Where is it?
So one day these also drop. 2B.
No, we are coming to that. We have not yet finished.
Everybody is gone, no? All of them.
So, mind is molecular.
Memory, cellular, memory.
Brain is physical kind.
Cellular.
So, brain is just lying there. There are live cells in it.
And what is happening is mind. Now, let's go ahead.
How do we take advantage of brain cells in for mind thing?
This is what I'm telling you. You pause.
Pause.
No, but pausing is also through mind, right?
Right, but then just it has to have a chemical counterpart. No? There is some cells of the brain which were till now dormant have now got activated.
By pausing. Mm-hmm. So basically, Jyoto, brain does not have as much importance as mind does.
No, because in the end, the expression will be through the brain. There is some area of the brain which was dormant will now suddenly start working.
Isn't that brain is just an instrument, yeah. And manas is the one which is, you know, it's a medium for
I mean, it's a manas is a molecular thing. Whoever must have understood it or put it in front of us must have seen it. I mean.
Okay, now we have come in here. This is brain 2B, right? Mm. Now our pause from 1 second it goes to 10 seconds.
That's what I was mentioning, correlating to that.
How many thoughts?
1200.
It goes in and it, on the way to this registration area, it will go through brain number 3. This brain number 3 is universal. Divine mind.
I see. So it's really a question of pause and that didn't say
I'm not going into this.
No,
what it means.
It's okay.
What it means.
That's okay.
But it has something to do with the mind means three forces. Tron, good.
Tron?
Good. Where to him now life is not people, life is not events, life is not anything, it is just a play of three gunas. He sees the play of the three gunas. You say an accident happened to me on the road, he will say I was going on the road, Rajas and Tamas came to meet me. This is the law of life. That's it. Nothing else. In those gunas, you are not there, my son is not there, my wife is not there, no one is there, it is just tamas, rajas and sattva, because it is pure mind.
So there the person sees as is.
There he sees the real cause behind everything, which is nothing but a play of the gunas.
But clearly, and that's what you are saying. How do you get that 10 seconds?
What is that?
This 10 seconds is called as?
Dharna.
Dhyana.
Oh, Dhyana. Okay, 12 seconds is Dhyana. I see.
1 second.
Then he increases his pause to?
100 seconds.
And on the way, he goes through this brain, and he comes to this brain number
4,
Bindu, where the divine fragment is sitting. But he doesn't meet, he meets the light of the divine fragment, the divine center. Samadhi.
That's Samadhi stage. That is meditation stage.
That is meditation, this is Samadhi. Dharana. Dhyana
and Samadhi.
So when he meets divine fragment, is this when you say you see the light?
It's all light only. It's all light.
2B પછી બધું લાઈટ જ છે.
Now he has gone beyond the 3
gunas.
Gunas also.
So gunas was up to that these
brain number 3.
Oh, that was gunas. That was the play of gunas, I see. And 4 is just the light.
સમજાય છે? Three screens of light. One screen I see you, the other screen I see brain 2B seeing you, I am full of anger, brain 2B, but that anger is nothing but a play of the three forces, the third screen. He is seeing life in three screens simultaneously. And in the fourth thing he says, nothing is happening outside of myself, it is all happening within myself, aham. Fit.
Second B individual mind. 2B, 2A individual mind.
2A shallow memory. 2B deep memory.
Deep memory.
Brain number 3 universal mind. Haan. Brain number 4 divine center.
But shallow memory and deep memory more individual mind. Haan. Haan. Individual mind. Rajen bhai ek prashna puchu. A flash je thai che ema 2B sudhi no experience hoy che ke total hoy?
2B.
2B sudhi no hoy.
Je you get those sudden satoris, those flashes. It's 2B. You've gone into 2B. It's such a... Because time is compressed. It's like BG, it's like expand. Space is expand. So this is it. The brains. In a very basic... I don't want to go into more detail now. I think this should be enough today. No?
Of course. And then, Rajen, thought me channel, you have to start with
this. Right.
So, you go to the hospital and go to the hospital. And go
to the hospital? No, go to the
hospital.
If you can please if you can please take a few moments just to start from the beginning, kind of summary, summarizing, that we will have an overview of the, because you know there's so much that
I know it is too much.
It is too much that my mind cannot
Initially, we said there's something like incoming impulse.
Okay.
It means identical memory pattern in the medium of manas.
Okay.
Right? Forms a thought which is a reaction. Thoughts are 120. It goes to registration area where it is verbalized in 12 forms. Or 16. Right? This is the state of 2, 4, 8. Again, incoming impulse comes in, identical memory pattern comes, but here we pause the manas.
Okay.
5 to 2.
And that pause would be fraction of a second.
Fraction of a second. We don't allow the pattern to meet incoming impulse. So this pattern dies. This is moksha, freedom. Because one pattern which was binding us for thousands of years is gone.
No.
Right? 5, 2, 2. The resultant is 1, now no longer 2, it's devoid of aggressiveness. Right? Okay? So this will be 5, 2, 2. Then we pause for 1 second. Save 120 thoughts. That energy opens the central brain cavity, Brahmarandra, and goes into brain 2B. This gives us very powerful perception.
This gives us very powerful perception.
Because now, what would take us 70 years to understand, we can understand in three minutes. So,
this is how the seeds now, that's what they're
right? So this is brain 3A. Diagram 3?
3,
okay. Right? Then we pause for 10 seconds. Right? Same 1200 thoughts. We move into brain number 3. This is UDM, Universal Divine Mind, the three forces. Life is a play of
three forces.
સમજો છો? આ પકડાય છે આ થ્રી ફોર્સીસ. આપણે કોઈને કેવું છે કે ભાઈ તારા લાઈફમાં ફ્રોમ ટુમોરો પેઇન ઓર સફરિંગ ઇઝ કમિંગ, તો વોટ વિલ વી સી?
ટામસ ઇઝ કમિંગ ટુમોરો.
In his psychological structure, there is a lot of
tamas,
which is going to invite events which will bring in more tamas and lead him into suffering. So, because now we can see the play of the three forces. The three gunas. Samjhe?
So that's how they see, okay. You know,
સામે વાળા ને જોઈને જ ખબર પડી જાય કે આ આની સાથે આવો.
The minute he says it, you know he is going to fail or win or fail, or whether he is going to કઈ suffering માં ચાલો જવાનું છે, કારણ કે તમને ગુણ દેખાય છે.
Oh, you are seeing in that particular person which is the predominant guna and what is going to invite more. That's what, in other words, the structure.
See, there's a whole science of gunas which we have not gone into, how they work, how they operate, right? So we have been dharana, dhyana, and finally when we pause for
100 seconds,
samadhi, we enter the divine center, and brain number 4.
That's the brain number
4. Patanjali does not stop here. Then from this third chapter, he says, Trayam Ekatra Sayam. He does not stop here.
This should be aage ja sakte hain.
So this is brain number 3.
C. This is 3C. Somehow I read that they said that when you are in 3C, you are like a Buddha.
Yes. And then the different sayams come in.
How 3C?
Brain number 3C. 10 seconds 3B. 1 second 3A.
1 second 3A. 10 second 3B. And 100 second 3C.
2, 4, 8. 5, 2, 2. 3A, 3B, 3C. That the Yoga Sutra does not get over here.
But let me ask you, Rajan, what is the ratio of this? It's not anymore 5-2-2-1. It is then the play of gunas.
5-2-2 is we are over. Now we've gone with 5-2-2.
So it's gone.
To move from 2-4-8
to 5-2-1, and that comes up to 3-8. Up to what stage?
Till you reach 1 second.
1 second.
Then you are in Dharna. Then you reach Dhyana in 10 seconds. And then you are in Samadhi in 100 seconds.
Okay, so I hear people going trance. What is going in trance?
It's not humble. You can stop your thoughts, but you are not really pausing it in normal relative life. I may sit like this and pause my thoughts.
I know someone who, she goes in trance. I mean, she's doing something and she's not on this plane, she says.
Samjhi gyo? Is she married? With children, at least you have to find out how a relationship is in normal living. Then it's the same thing.
That is
how it is implemented in day to day life. That's what he means.
That's the test of it. No?
Say it again.
You have to ask her children and husband and all. Hey, is she still getting irritated? Is she then? You know, then the trance could be little dicey. What is her normal life?
Are you living the life with the that
the way I see her, mane lage che ke tum jo if that if you are connected, but I just wanted to know, okay, to go into trance is similar to this?
You don't have to go into trance to do this, but you can.
No. She doesn't go into. Just naturally she goes.
That is what I'm trying to say. Naturally is not in our control.
Right. So it should be in our control.
And nowhere are we talking about trance here. This is, we are living our normal life and doing this.
But the stage is similar.
Stage is similar, but you see, many times a trance could be a negative state because I can get into a trance by just taking the drug.
Yeah, but
I'm not understanding you. A maximum of a trance ne gano ne to a brain 2B ma jai. But deep je epilepsy ne badu thai che. Any under actually they are in brain 3. Epilepsy. We don't know what kind of trance. But what Tavadiya ji is talking about is a normal life. He has nothing to do by sitting in meditation and going into trance. He is just talking about living your normal every day.
But a bigger question is that Mayank bhai ne jo, right? So Mayank bhai.
She can please say Nishal.
Sorry.
That's okay. No problem.
So when I see him, he lives his life very disciplinary way. He avoids a lot of outer activities and whatnot.
It sends its ray. This ray is jeev.
Okay.
Now once the ray leaves the sun, in nikrigyu, it gets covered by clothes.
What do you recommend?
Covered with what?
Clothes. Matter.
Okay, I got it.
Okay, so once it leaves sun.
This matter is planetary. That is why it is called astral body.
It is planetary?
It is called astral body. In Gurujiya, it is called as essence. Or astral body. So, jeev means two things. One, light of Atma plus surrounded by planetary matter or in planetary body.
Surrounded by planetary
matter.
Very good.
All sanskars are made of planetary matter.
All sanskars. In other words, the sanskars are being affected by the planets. Is that correct?
They are made of the planets. Okay. If I am angry, it is made of Mars. If I am happy, it is made of Jupiter.
Excuse me, Amar, okay. His sun is Atma. There is a ray, which is Jeev. Once the ray leaves sun, it gets covered by the matter. And it is planetary.
Very
good. Okay. Then Jeev is same thing, right? Ray.
Ray, in a Gurjeev, real eye. Real eye. Jeev ne real eye. Sacho eye.
Real eye. Okay.
And Jeev je matter thi surrounded che. In essence.
So, Jeev means, which is ray of light, means light of Atma.
Light of Atma nikri gyu, it has left the Atma.
It has left the Atma.
Now it is making a journey.
And it is Jeev. It has become Jeev.
Soul. Soul. Jeev. It is soul.
Jeev or soul. Okay.
Now it is taking a long journey. Like this body is taking a journey of 70 years. That takes a journey of a long journey till it reaches the Atma back again.
So this particular soul, which is the ray of Atma, is made of the planetary substance
plus light of the Atma.
Plus the light of the Atma. And when you say the matter and the light will separate, that's what you mean, will do it, you know, this holding thing is what you're saying.
Supposing it gets fragmented into so many sanskars. Jeev.
વચ્ચેથી જ ડ્રોપ થઈ ગઈ છે એટલે મને આમાંથી કંઈ નથી સમજ પડી અને આઈ મીન એક્સક્યુઝ મી વોટ એવર ઇટ ઇઝ પણ મને નથી ખ્યાલ આવતો કે સન છે સન ઇઝ
એક સૂર્ય છે એમાંથી એક કિરણ બહાર નીકળે
બહાર નીકળે
એક નીકળું એટલે ત્યાં કટ ઓફ થઈ
ગયું
કારણ કે ડ્રોપ ઇન વાઇબ્રેશન્સ એ કિરણને એમને રહેવાની છૂટ નથી એને કપડાં પહેરવા જ પડે
બરાબર
એ કપડાં જે એને મળે છે એ ગ્રહોના કપડાં મળે
બરાબર
વાય એને પ્લેનેટરી બીકોઝ એને કિરણ બહાર શું કામ મોકલું છે કારણ શું છે વાય હેઝ ઇટ સેન્ટ ઇટ્સ રે ટુ એક્સપિરિયન્સ ઓલ એક્સપિરિયન્સ ઇઝ લાય ઇન ધ પ્લેનેટ્સ સો દેટ પ્લેનેટરી મેટર ઇઝ ગિવન ટુ એક્સપિરિયન્સ But instead of making that universal experience, it makes an individual experience.
Right.
And the new chitta is formed. Chitta is memory
okay.
of the experience. Mm-hmm. And that changes the planetary matter
okay.
into Eventually. Individual sanskar. Mm-hmm. So the original shape of Mars changes into anger or irritation. Mm-hmm. So Mars, the original shape has gone. Now, if he gets the original shape, pacho, it can go back into the sun. But till it gets rid of all this, changes all the shape of all the anger, it cannot go back. And it keeps on increasing in its journey. So, all the sanskars are made of planetary matter. And that is what the structure is. So, if that structure changes, the jeev can go back. Now, the jeev is entrapped in each sanskar also individually. એટલે સપોઝિંગ આઈ એમ એંગ્રી વિથ યુ એન્ડ આઈ ઓબ્ઝર્વ દેટ એંગર એટ વન પોઈન્ટ આઈ એમ ફ્રી ઓફ દેટ એંગર તો જેટલો એ પ્રકાશ એ સંસ્કારમાં ફસાયેલો હતો ધી અમાઉન્ટ ઓફ લાઇટ ટ્રેપ્ડ ઇન દેટ ઇઝ સડનલી ફ્રી સો ધેર સડનલી એન એક્સપિરિયન્સ ઓફ અવેકનિંગ એનલાઇટન્ડ અરે આઈ એમ ફ્રી
સો ઇટ ઇઝ ઓ ધેટ્સ વાય ધે સે યુ ગેટ રિડ ઓફ ધીસ ઇગોઇઝમ એન્ડ
સો યાત્રા જીવ કરે છે આત્મા યાત્રા નથી કરતો આ સમજાય છે એ જીવ જે છૂટું પડ્યું આત્મામાંથી કવર્ડ બાય પ્લેનેટ એ લાંબી યાત્રા કરે છે આત્મા તો ત્યાં ને ત્યાં જ પડ્યો છે
સો ઇન ધીસ જર્ની વી ગેટ મેની બર્થ એન્ડ
યા ઇટ કેન વી ગેટ બર્થ ઇટ કીપ્સ ઓન લુકિંગ ફોર સેટ્સ ઓફ પેરેન્ટ્સ
આમ આ મને કેમ કન્ફ્યુઝન થાય છે ખબર છે કારણ કે ધ વર્ડ્સ ધેટ વી યુઝ ઇન અ જનરલ ટર્મ આત્મા ઇઝ ઓલવેઝ સેડ ઇઝ લાઈક અવર ઓન આત્મા નોટ ધ સન સન આત્મા
નોટ યુ સે અવર ઓન ડિવાઇન ફ્રેગમેન્ટ એઝ અ સન our own Tamangoro.
I think other way, other people say Paramatma as the sun
right.
and then the ray as the Atma.
Atma, exactly. I think that's why the confusion. That doesn't make,
you take it that way, take it that way, but that ray is covered by planetary matter, it becomes jeev.
Okay, so Paramatma is also our inner soul?
Our inner soul, you see, when the Shastra says that Atma and Paramatma are the same.
Right.
So we are just taking Atma as the sun. Forget the Paramatma.
Right. So here you are stating Atma as a Paramatma because it's the same.
Same. And the ray which comes out is the jeev.
Jeev.
But that jeev cannot live alone. It has to live with planetary matter.
Right.
That planetary matter is essence.
Okay. So here Atma is divine fragment.
No.
So that divine fragment which is part of Paramatma only will go one day...
Forget there is anything like Paramatma.
Okay.
Once the Atma realizes itself, it is Paramatma.
Okay.
No,
so we do not go... Okay. So everything is just in there only.
Right.
So, it's very interesting and it's very valuable.
No, I have to understand.
So this jeev, once it leaves the as a ray from the sun,
it keeps on taking birth.
So keep on taking birth into the planetary matter and the reason because it is accumulating the sanskar because of reaction. And once we pass then
it goes back.
Then it goes, it's getting free of this and then the Atma goes back.
Right.
So sun and Atma is also inside and the jeev is whatever we are.
Because the Atma has to enter to make the child cry. At the point of entering, it makes the child cry. આત્મા યાત્રા નથી કરતું, યાત્રા જીવ કરે છે. ઇઝ જસ્ટ સિટિંગ
વોટ ઇઝ ચિત્ત
ચિત્ત ઇઝ ટુ અટેન્શન ઇઝ ઓલસો ચિત્ત એન્ડ મેમરી ઇઝ ઓલસો
ચિત્ત
ચિત્ત ઇઝ માઇન્ડ.
આઈ નો તમને આ બધું ઇરિટેશન થતું હશે, બહુ સ્ટુપિડ ક્વેશ્ચન પૂછું છું, પણ મને તમે એવું કહો છો કે આત્મા મેક્સ જીવ ક્રાય ઓર સોલ જીવ, હા, રે ઓફ એટ ધ ટાઈમ ઓફ ધ બર્થ આત્મા મેક્સ ઇટ ક્રાય, રાઈટ? આત્મા, તમે એકવાર એવું કીધું કે આત્મા ઇઝ જસ્ટ ઇન અસ.
સો એટ ધ ટાઈમ ઓફ ધ યાત્રા નથી કરતું, ઇટ સ્ટેઝ ઇન વન પ્લેસ. એટ ધ ટાઈમ ઓફ એન્ટરિંગ ધ ન્યુ બોડી ઇટ મેક્સ ઇટ ક્રાય, સો ધ it starts living.
So this is my body, right? And atma mara body ma j, atma is inside my body,
right?
Like, when I leave this body, you are saying that
the jeev takes the atma to swahalok, leaves it over there, it does a journey, the jeev takes on a new body, and when the new body is on the point of crying, the atma enters again.
So jeev goes with Atma.
Leaves it in Swaha. Mahakal.
Okay.
And then Jeev does Yatra in Bhuvalok.
Now it is. So when we die, we leave body here, but Jeev takes Atma.
Leaves it at its place.
Then
it does a journey in Bhuvalok.
What? Jeev.
That journey of 55 days or whatever it does in Bhuvalok,
right,
decides to take a new birth.
Right.
At the point of the new birth, the Atma comes again to meet the Jeev.
See, now everything makes sense. Okay, so...
Right? It makes the new sanskars on the 7th month.
So, Jeev keeps Atma for 55 days or till it finds out that he wants or she wants to be born. Keeps it there. When it's ready, I've decided set of parents. Jeev, Atma
is not involved in anything.
In selection.
Not involved in anything.
To its source anyway, and then the jeep travels in the bulo, and then goes into the and then once it takes off, then the atma meets it, and then the journey.
So this is nice.
See, without the atma, there can be no self-awareness.
Oh, I see.
So that self-awareness is needed for the jeep to be free.
And what happens during the pregnancy?
Then we'll talk another day now. I think this is more than enough for today.